Hello, and welcome to Botfield. Today we're going to talk about Astar, one of the most commonly used path planning algorithms. The algorithms we have talked about so far explore the map from the starting node outward, regardless of the location of the goal. This includes Dijkstra's algorithm and the wavefront algorithm. But this is unrealistic. If you know the direction your goal is in, you're going to start looking in that direction, even if you don't know what detours you may take on the way. People do this every day. They try to make progress towards their goal, hit some obstacles, make their way around them, and keep going. This method of finding a path from start to goal is similar to greedy best first search. There is a map with a goal and a robot on it. The robot doesn't know what the map looks like, but it knows where the goal is. Of the spots where it can move, which one should it explore first? The robot will decide using a heuristic. A heuristic is an equation that estimates the path length, or cost, to go from one place to another. Heuristics can be calculated in many different ways depending on your application. For pathfinding, the most common heuristic is the straight line distance, also known as the Euclidean distance. Moving from one point to another in a straight line is the shortest possible path you could take from one place to another. If your robot can only move vertically and horizontally, you can use the Manhattan distance. The Manhattan distance adds the vertical and horizontal distance needed to get to a goal and uses that as the heuristic. The heuristic must be less than or equal to the actual path cost, but not larger. Why does the heuristic have to be smaller? Let's say we have all these nodes, and we have a goal. And we use a heuristic to estimate the cost to get from the nodes to the goal. Which node will have the shortest path to the goal? All we have right now are estimates, so Tangle won't know until he actually travels the path. Let's say he travels this path, and he finds that the path is 10 long. Does he need to explore the path from the other nodes to the goal before he is sure he has found the shortest path? If the heuristic can be longer than the actual path length, then yes, because this path, for example, could be 9 long. If the heuristic must be less than or equal to the actual path length, you know that every other path will be equal to or longer in length than the estimate. That means Tango can be sure he has found the shortest path with only the estimates of the path length from the other nodes. So, the heuristic can never be larger than the smallest possible cost. Let's take a look at this in action with greedy best first search. When assigning a cost to a square, we're going to use the straight line distance as our heuristic. After assigning all the costs to the places where the robot could move, the algorithm picks the one with the smallest cost as the most promising node. The algorithm will also remember where the nodes came from, so that it can trace a path back to the start. Let's take a look at the map the way the algorithm sees it. It doesn't know where the obstacles are yet, so it makes sense that it would travel up towards the goal first. If it reaches a point where there are two squares with the same number, it picks one at random. The robot will move anywhere in the explored area that has the smallest value, jumping around if necessary. The area is expanded pretty evenly until the robot gets around the obstacle, and the value of the squares begins decreasing consistently. Greedy best first search explored far fewer squares than previous algorithms, but the path that the algorithm found is not exactly optimal. I should note that I used a map which I knew would be problematic for the greedy algorithm, and that it does sometimes find the shortest path. But let's take a look at why it failed. The greedy algorithm only examines the distance from its current position to the goal, never the path from the start to the current position. The path to a given spot is determined on a first-come, first-served basis. That means that it remembers the first path it found to a node, and if it finds a shorter path to it, it doesn't do anything about it. This causes the algorithm to sometimes take detours. So Dijkstra's algorithm looks only at distances from the start to a node, and the greedy algorithm looks only at distances from a node to the goal. But a path is made up of both the path from the start to a node and the path from the node to the goal. This is where Astar comes in. To assign a number to a square, Astar uses a heuristic from the square to the goal, and it adds it to the shortest path it has found to the square so far. The square's value is the length of the shortest possible path to the goal that goes through that node. If the algorithm finds a path to a square that is shorter than the one it had, it replaces it. Here's an example. For all the first squares, the cost to move there, 1, is added to the heuristic for that square. From these values, Astar picks the smallest and explores this one. Let's see how it plays out. Astar finds the estimated path cost for the squares next to its position. The smallest square is down a different path, though, so the algorithm changes gears and goes there. In fact, the algorithm often jumps around to explore the smallest node first. Astar explored nearly the same number of squares as the greedy algorithm, but found the shortest path to the goal. You might have noticed that it explored a few squares that brought it further from the goal. We told the algorithm that if it went down, the shortest path it could find to the goal was a straight line. But the robot can't actually move like that. Going down and then going in a straight line to the goal is shorter than going up and around like this. So, according to the information we gave the algorithm, it was exploring a path that could have been shorter than what it had already found. We can fix this by not using the straight line distance, but instead using the Manhattan distance, since that's more accurate to what the robot can actually do. And this is what the final map looks like if you use the Manhattan distance. It finds the same path, but it does so slightly faster, and you end up with a lot of 11s and 13s. Astar is only as good as the heuristic you give it. The closer your heuristic is to the actual path your robot can take, the faster the algorithm will find the shortest path. Astar is often used on graphs and maps. Astar works faster than Dijkstra's because it doesn't explore unnecessary nodes. This is even more evident and important on larger graphs. In future videos, we'll talk about how algorithms can deal with negative costs and optimizing for really big graphs. If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, make sure to leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe for more content. Thank you.